what I long for. Holiness is what I need. Holiness, holiness is what you want for me.
Hi everybody, my name is Shameka. I was invited to speak about guarding your environment and how people can enhance godliness or prevent growth. So thank you, Pastor Lavelle, for asking me to speak about this. Like, what a great topic. So let's pray and then we'll get into it. Heavenly Father, we invite you into this environment. Thank you so much for this opportunity to speak about things that are so important to your people and ways that we can continue to grow and to be more like you. I pray that you touch every single person that watches this video in a way that they know it only came straight from you, Lord God. Love on your people, speak to your people, Lord God. I pray that you also speak to me and use me as your vessel in this moment to deliver whatever you want me to deliver to your people. I thank you for it, Lord God. Have your way. Move however you see fit. We thank you for it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, so if you see me looking down, I'm looking at my notes. If you see me looking this way, I'm looking at my Bible. So last week, Pastor Lavelle talked about deciding to be a follower of Christ and to be God's ambassador and living by the Spirit. So of course, 2 Corinthians 5:20, I can read it. I'm gonna get my Bible. 2 Corinthians 5:20 says, so we are Christ's ambassadors. God is making this appeal through us. We speak for Christ when we plead, come back to God. For God made Christ, who never sinned, to be the offering for our sin, so that we could be made right with God through Christ. Okay, also the verse, we are in this world, but not of this world. Jesus said he was not of this world, so his people are not of this world as well. It is a choice, right, to follow Christ. And it's not just a choice that you make once, right? It's made daily, every single day, deciding to match your desires with what his word says and what his will says, because that's difficult. The flesh wants what the flesh wants, when the flesh wants what it wants, right? So also Pastor Lavelle talked about 2 Peter 1, and I'll read that too. This is just a recap if anybody did not see it. So yeah, 2 Peter 1 through 3, oh sorry, 3 through 4, but I'll read until 7 because the next verse is about that as well. So 2 Peter chapter 1, I'm gonna start at verse 3 and then finish with 7. By his divine power, God has given us everything we need for living a godly life. We have received all this by coming to him, the one who called us to himself, by means of his marvelous glory and excellence. And because of his glory and excellence, he has given us great and precious promises. These are the promises that enable you to share his divine nature and escape the world's corruption caused by human desires. In view of all this, make every effort to respond to God's promises. Supplement your faith with a generous provision of moral excellence, and moral excellence with knowledge, and knowledge with self-control, and self-control with patient endurance, and patient endurance with godliness, and godliness with brotherly affection, and brotherly affection with love for everyone. Okay? Good verses, right? So that's how to actually live godly. All right, so now we're going to talk about how to bring all of that and living godly into our relationships. That means with our families, with our peers, with our coworkers, with our boyfriend, with our girlfriend. How do we actually implement that in our relationships, right? Because sometimes we can get knowledge and we're reading the Bible and we're like, okay, I got it down. But then you actually have to go out into the world and actually bring all of that knowledge that you have and put it into action, which is more difficult than actually just reading a verse and being like, I got this, we cool, right? So I want to bring us to actually being set apart. Like I said, it's easy to read a verse, but then in action, it's like, well, how do I actually do this, right? So if we're supposed to live set apart, and the Bible says to come out from among them, meaning come out from the world, we should be that example. We should be that pillar, that standard that people are seeking to be like. And I can read that verse too. That verse is 2 Corinthians 6 and 17. So it says, Actually, I'll read the verse before it. And what union can there be between God's temple and idols? For we are the temple of the living God. As God said, I will live in them and walk among them. I will be their God, and they will be my people. Therefore, come out from among unbelievers and separate yourselves from them, says the Lord. Don't touch their filthy things, and I will welcome you. And I will be your father, and you will be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Okay, so does that mean because we're set apart that we just don't hang with unbelievers? We just run from people that are different than us? No, right? No. We're supposed to be in those groups, be at work, be in our family. Sometimes we have family members that don't believe what we believe, right? Or we have coworkers that don't believe what we believe. We don't run from that though. We bring even more Jesus to those relationships, right? We are very aware that we are the example in those relationships, and we're cognizant of the Holy Spirit working through us. We got to pray more, be more sensitive to the Spirit, right? So an example would be of my training for one of my programs for my nonprofit last week. I had a spiritual, I don't want to say spiritual person, a minister come in and offer a training on spiritual support. I had to remind her that everybody believes in different things, but we want to provide spiritual support for our program. So to touch on like how we can enhance that within our team. Okay, so she says, Shameka, I'm not going to go in and like be talking about the Bible and all this stuff, but just know that when people don't believe in Christianity, we are the first ones that they come to and they ask for prayer. They ask for support. We're always the first ones. So it doesn't matter if I preach about the Bible or this or that. I am an example of him and the people are going to come to me regardless. Can I get some snaps? Yeah, so when we are trying to live godly, it doesn't just mean in our prayer time, at church, in our Bible studies, right? We want to bring that into all of our relationships. All right, so my second point would be create an environment where peace dwells. Where peace dwells. Have y'all been to like a spa and you walk in and you're like, oh my gosh, the stress is just melting away, right? Which is why we like going to the spa. We like getting massages. We like comfortable and peaceful environments. So John 17, 27. I actually don't have it marked. So I'm gonna find it. Oops, I think I said the wrong words. John 14, 27. Did I say that? Hopefully I said that. John 14, 27 says, I am leaving you with a gift. A gift. Y'all know when we get a gift and we like, oh, I got a gift. Or an Amazon package. An Amazon package. We be like, oh, I got a package today. Let me go and check. Right? We get so excited. He said, I am leaving you with a gift. Peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift that the world cannot give. So don't be troubled. Or some verses says, don't let your heart be troubled or afraid. And then the next one, remember what I told you, I'm going away. Okay. Do not let your heart be troubled. Do not let your heart be troubled. His peace, he leaves with us. So often we're seeking self-care tips and do-it-yourself tips and mindfulness and all this, right? God is saying, I have given you my peace. It's a gift. Here you go. Take my peace. Keep my peace. Dwell in my peace, right? So then also we have to think about the Holy Spirit. The Bible says, do not grieve the Holy Spirit. I can read that as well. Because this goes together. Okay, so Ephesians. Ephesians 4 and 30, it says, do not bring sorrow to God's Holy Spirit by the way that you live. Remember, he has identified you as his own, guaranteeing that you will be saved on the day of redemption. Okay? So, when you have this peace of the Holy Spirit and the peace of God, right? You, when you live in a way that contradicts his spirit, that peace feels like it's shaky, it's gone. It's not there, right? So if we have things in our environment that is contradicting God's peace, we have to restore that peace and bring our lives under submission of the Holy Spirit. Of course, by asking the Holy Spirit what to do now. God, is there something that you don't like? Oftentimes when we grieve the Holy Spirit, we feel the, sometimes we feel the something may not be right. Something's off. I feel weird. You know, we get that feeling in our stomach, right? So oftentimes when we grieve the Holy Spirit, it can lead to being aware of sin or missing the mark. And examples of that would be like, for me, if I'm in an environment where everybody's smoking and drinking and cussing and we turning up and everybody's twerking, I get that, it's just something not right, right? I'm not at full peace. Like God said, he gives us his fullness of joy. When we're in his presence and when our environment is including God and we're at one with the Holy Spirit, there is joy. You're able to breathe freely, right? When I'm gossiping or talking about somebody and I feel the, the Holy Spirit's like, that's not it. You just missed the mark. Right? So we need to create an environment where his peace dwells. And then also our friends, who are we around? Who are we bringing into our circle? I have a whole bunch of homeboys that's smoking weed 24/7, turning up 24/7. And when I go into that environment, God says, the Bible says in Proverbs 27:17, iron sharpens iron, right? So if I'm going into that environment and I'm trying to be sharpened and it's like I'm surrounded by a whole bunch of people and it's wood and I'm trying to sharpen, is it going to sharpen me? If I'm iron, right, and I'm trying to be sharpened, it's going to dull me, right? It's not going to sharpen it. Now, if I surround myself with people and they're on a level where I'm trying to get to, like, let's take this as an example. If I want to be a pastor, right, and I'm hanging out at parties and twerking and doing all this, is it going to sharpen that desire for me to want to be a pastor? No, it's going to start to like dull it, right, and decrease it. Now, if I want to be a pastor and I'm hanging out with Pastor Lavelle 24/7 and I'm asking questions and I want to know about his life and I'm studying his lifestyle, he is already on this level, right? So that's iron, sharpening iron. I'm getting stronger. He's helping me. I'm helping him, hopefully. Hopefully I'm contributing something to his environment as well. And we are both growing together, right? So they say you are the sum total of like the five people that you hang out with the most. And then people are like, oh, that's cliche. No, that's truth. Who are you hanging out with? Who are you listening to? Who is sharpening your iron? Who's sharpening you? What do you choose to surround yourself with? What are you listening to? What are you watching on television? Can't speak. On television. You know what I mean? If we want a godly environment, we want to hang out with godly people. We want to listen to stuff that is godly. We want to read books that are godly. How are we doing this? Every single day. Every single day. Okay? I have four ways that we can impact our environment and enhance a godly environment and ultimately grow, right? We want to be more like Christ. We want to be better in life. So yeah, I'm going to put these four steps and then I'll actually like create like a Canva post and then put it on there with the Bible verses that goes with it as well. Okay. So number one, make the decision to follow Christ daily. Daily. Wake up and think, okay, Lord, I want to cultivate your peace in my environment. I want to be a godly influence for you. It's a choice every single day because this flesh is crazy. It's crazy. So today I'm doing it. Tomorrow I'm like, nah, this ain't for me, fam. No, we have to renew our minds and put our flesh in perspective every single day. Okay, so make the decision to follow Christ. That comes from Luke 9:23. Number two, be led by his spirit. Remember Pastor Lavelle's message from last week in the whole chapter one of 2 Peter. Okay, be led by his spirit. Our flesh is like emotional and grumpy and all this stuff. It just wants random stuff all the time, you know? So we have to be like, Holy Spirit, what do you want me to do today? How can I be more like you today? Lord God, is there something that is grieving your spirit? Is there something I need to remove from my environment? Is there somebody that I need to talk to today? Is there somebody I need to pray for today? Okay, so be led by the Spirit. Number three, take authority over the access that you have to God's peace. He said, I leave my peace with you. So that means if you don't have the peace, where is it? He gave you full access to his peace. Step into that. Hone that. I refuse to be in an environment where I feel not at rest and not peaceful. Y'all see my plants? Like, I need an environment that is peaceful, where I can hear the Holy Spirit. I can do what the Holy Spirit is telling me to do. So that's number three. And also that comes from John 14. All right, number four. Create relationships that encourage you to grow and to become more like Christ. Who are your counselors? Right? In the multitude of counselors, there is safety. That's Proverbs 11:14. Who are your counselors? Who are you with every single day or every week? Which coworkers are you hanging out with the most? Let's be honest. The ones that y'all just gossiping and chilling and talking, or the ones that's keeping you accountable, sharpening you, encouraging you, right? What kind of boyfriend or girlfriend do you have? I mean, if you're already married, you know, that that's a whole other subject. But what kind of friends and peers are around you? What kind of church members are you in constant communication with? What type of posts are you looking at on Facebook and Instagram and TikTok and Twitter? Are we allowing what is coming into our minds to encourage us to grow? Or is it preventing us? Is it making us more like Christ or more like the world? So that's all I have. I'm going to pray. Share this with whoever may need this. Be encouraged, okay? So yeah, let's pray. Heavenly Father, I pray that this message takes root in your people's hearts, Lord God. Build them up, strengthen them, give them the necessary tools to be the people that you have called them to be. Boldly, Lord God. You say your peace that you leave with us, Lord God. Help us to proclaim that and to walk in your peace every single day, Lord Jesus. I pray blessings and a covering over your people. Help them to be more like you. Help them to choose your path and to pick up their cross every single day, no matter how uncomfortable, no matter how difficult it is, Lord God. I pray that you continue to sharpen them. Also, help them to ask for help, ask for guidance, ask for prayer when they may need it. Give them strong counsel, Lord God, counsel after your own heart. Thank you, Lord God. I pray all of these things in your son's name, Lord God, and I thank you that you bless your people through this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I love y'all.
Lightly, won't fall, be bold, let's live godly. We won't tiptoe, won't step lightly, won't fall, be bold, let's live godly.
They say, do what's that with homie, otherwise you'll be sitting at home lonely. your Christianity. Makes you a slave to your sanity. Don't care, you ain't a fan of me. No. I'll take your jokes and your mockery. While the father is proud of me, I would have bowed to the Akala Kawali.
Yeah.
It's easy to go with the trends, but all of your friends in this new age.
Yeah.
Christians don't care about sin, so they learn in the bin, so they burn sage. What a huge mistake they take it from a witch page. Look into astronomy, ass face. Igniting a holy God with rage. Temptation every hand, I ain't playing. I'm just saying, I ain't praying that we're standing in this plan. Not abandoning our fandom. He fashioned the plan. This is random, I'm saying, I'm planning. The word on my heart. The Holy Spirit got me seeking truth like a canine. It's got me seeing all the hypocrites with Christian written on the head with a crayon.
So keep going, the path is still golden. I'm not a theologian, but my heart is still for him.
I gotta be bold, yeah. I know it's not old,
yeah.
I'm told go along with the slope, but the slope would choke out the path that I chose.
One word, tiptoe, one step, lightly,
lightly.
One fall, be bold, let's live godly. We won't tiptoe, one step, lightly,
lightly.
One fall, be bold, let's live godly.
We just want to live godly. I don't really care if you truly do not like me. We just want to live godly. I don't really care if you truly do not like me.
They say self-love is the key. What's wrong with the world, so learn how to love you.
Love
but self-love, it results in greed and lust. So to say it's the key is untrue. Wars and genocide, man won't kill his pride. All the result of self-love. Self-love is our default, we don't struggle with this. On my prayer, Lord God, help us. The key is to know how much God really loves you. He came in the flesh, took our sins in his death. Also his wrath when it crushed you. They say, don't judge. When somebody's deceased, at the drop of a hat, turn around and put somebody in heaven with rest and peace. Thank a stranger every day, yet they're foreign. Just because we pray doesn't mean we know I'm singing, shouting, the church going through the motions. Doesn't mean a thing if there's no true devotion. Help us not to be a hypocrite. Help worship go beyond our lips. Help us stand despite how hard it gets. Whether in a palace or a pit. Whipping me, killing me, the enemy. Enter me, be so weak, sin would be the enemy. So we flee adultery, fornication, lust me. Death to me is heavenly, but the spirit flesh ceased.
Answer, when he's calling. We just try to be godly. Dancing, I'm all in. Ain't nothing gonna stop me.
We won't tiptoe, won't step lightly. Won't fall, be bold, let's live godly. We won't tiptoe, won't step lightly. Won't fall, be bold, let's live godly.
We just want to live godly. I don't really care if you truly do not like me. We just want to live godly. I don't really care if you truly do not like me.